teaching the next generation of hydraulic mechanics. The Parker Denison Gold Cup. It doesn't take much to go wrong when fixing a 5,000 PSI piston pump. When we received this pump, the auxiliary shaft was snapped in half.
We do a full rebuild, yet it still fails the initial testing.
We replace the snap rings, the shaft bearing, the barrel bearing, the faceplate, the creep plate, the port plate, the piston assembly, the barrel, the valve block, the dual poppet valve, the servo seat, and all the seals.
Let's get this pump back together, then get it on the test stand to check our work.
It shouldn't just break like that. So once they get...
Now onto the test bench for testing.
I had an auxiliary shaft that was snapped in half. And that caused a lot of stress. So there's something that's not quite right. We don't know exactly what it is.
We quickly noticed that something was not right. The shaft was too stiff. We loosened the back plate and the shaft moved well, meaning there was something wrong internally.
Now you pull the main cartridge in. Because I think this may be the issue where it's twisted, and that's why it broke the original shaft.
We have to take the vane cartridge out. We're eliminating what possibly the problem is. What John, at this point, we figured we established, as soon as we loosened it off a bit, we could turn the shaft. So somewhere, either it was the rear cover, we should establish it wasn't, because we changed the cover just now. Because that's a different cover altogether,
yeah.
So it's not the cover. So we're going to take the cartridge out. What John suspected, that there's a misalignment. The problem is either there's something in the block here that's misaligning the auxiliary shaft. So if you have something on an angle and it's loose, then it doesn't matter. If, as soon as you tighten down on it and it's squeezed on an angle, it's preventing everything from moving.
And that's why we test.
Do you see that metal there? That's where that little pin goes into.
Yeah.
What we did, John says, why don't you take a pin off of one of these and just push it in. It is the pin, not sitting in flat.
Now we needed to determine if the problem was the pin or the cartridge. We put the cartridge back in and made sure it was sitting evenly. With this, the shaft was still too stiff.
Nope.
We then took out the charge rod and noticed that the pin was slightly askew.
Very carefully. It's pointing inwards a little. It's so minute, it's not even funny.
On to another test. We saw that one of the controls wasn't functioning, so we switched those and ran another test. See the power of testing. Without it, we wouldn't have noticed many critical issues with this pump. Thank you for watching.